Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about the carta d'identità and residence. We are going to be looking at what is carta d'identità, what is residence, and what are the differences between these two documents. Because a lot of people have been missing these two documents, have been confusing these two documents. A lot of people who have their carta d'identità thinks that is their residence, or the fact that they have carta d'identità means automatically they have residence. So today we are going to be taking a look at what is actually residence and what is the difference between residence and carta d'identità. Before we get right in, if today is your first time of joining us, or you've come across our video somewhere but you've not had that time to subscribe, so I want to implore you to click on the subscription button down below and hit also the notification button. In this way, you get notified of every video that we'll be bringing across your way. In the meantime, let's get into our discussion for today. So, like I said, today we are going to be talking about the residence and carta d'identità. What is residence? What is carta d'identità? And what is the difference between these two documents? Now, let's take a look at the word carta d'identità. Now, carta d'identità is an Italian word or an Italian translation for the English word identity card. That means carta d'identità is an identity card. So that brings us to the question, what is an identity card? An identity card, or ID as we may know it, is any document that may be used to prove a person's identity. If issued in a small standard credit card size form, it is usually called an identity card or an ID. The document is used to connect a person to information about the person, often in a database. The photo and the possession of it, that is the photo and the possession of this card, is used to connect the person with the document. The connection between the identity document and information database is based on personal information present on the document, such as the bearer's full name, age, birth date, address, and identification number, card number, gender, citizenship, and many more. That is to say, an identity card is just a means of identification. It is a card, just like your national ID card, that can be used to identify you. What is your name? What is your gender? Are you a male? Are you a female? Where do you stay? What is your date of birth? Where are you from? All of these details, it's just an identification card. That is to say, the carta d'identità, which is an identity card, is similar to your permesso di soggiorno. Why? They are all a means of identification. They are just an identification card, a means to identify you. Why, on the other hand, residence is entirely different. Now, let's take a look at the word residence. Residence, or a person's primary residence or main residence, is the dwelling place where they usually live. It could typically be a house or an apartment, but a person can only have one primary residence at any given time, though they may share the residence with other people. That is to say, the carta d'identità is just an identification card. Why the residence means where you stay, where you are staying. Now, let's take a very good example. You live in Roma. Every city or every commune have their anagraph, that is where they register the population of the people in that city. So when you register your residence, or when you are registered under the resident in that place, that is, if you're staying in the camp, your residence is registered under that camp. It means in the commune, it is registered that you are staying in that camp. When they put your name on the system, that place shows at your, as your address. So it is registered in the commune that you live in that place. That is your residence. Or you have a house, you rented an apartment with contract, and you registered it in the commune. So you are registered in the commune as a citizen of that city, of that commune, and your address is showing there, then you can now apply for an ID card. Simple. An ID card is your character identity. So you can have an ID card, which is character identity, that is valid for 10 years. But if you leave that house where you are staying, or you leave that city where you are staying, or you leave that camp where you are staying, you no longer have residence in that place, because your residence is your address where you stay. So this is an example. If I am staying in Roma, I live in the camp. The camp address is registered as my residence, and I have my character identity, which is just an ID card. If I leave that camp tomorrow and I go out of the camp, I can change city, or I remain in that city, automatically my residence is no longer in that place. If I rent a house, I need to go to commune to communicate to commune that I want to change my residence. I have changed house, so I am no longer staying in that street. I am no longer staying in that apartment where I was registered under. I have changed house, so I want to change my residence from that place, because I can still have my character identity, which is just an ID card. It is valid for 10 years. It is still valid, but that does not mean I have the residence. My residence was where I was staying. So as long as I'm no longer staying there, my residence automatically is no longer there. My residence should be where I am staying, because residence is where you are living, your address, that is your residence. So if I have not been able to transfer my residence in the commune from my old address to my new address, and somebody else enters into that house, or I used to stay in the camp and the camp people cancel my name from that address, they communicate to the commune that I'm no longer in that address, so the commune cancel my name from that address, automatically I don't have a residence. I have lost that residence. I can still have my character identity, which is just an identity card. But that does not prove my residence. Not until I have taken a house, I have registered myself in that city with that address, or I have asked for a transfer, a change of residence, transfer the residence from that old address to this new address, that is when automatically I have my residence. So that is to tell you, residence is different from character identity. Residence, when you have your residence, you can apply, you can ask for certificate of residence, which is a certificate that shows that you reside there. Just for example, those of us who are Nigerians, in Nigeria you have local government of origin, certificate of local government of origin. That certificate certifies that you are from that local government. That is the certificate of residence that certifies that you are from that city. You are living in that city officially. You are registered in the anagraphe of that city. That is your residence. So certificate of residence is the certificate that proves that you are registered in the anagraphe of that city. You are registered, you are legally registered in that city. It is different from your character identity. So take note, character identity is just an identification card. It's similar to your permesso di soggiorno. While on the other hand, residence is your official address where you are staying, or your official address that is officially registered with the anagraphe of that commune. So I don't know if you've gotten the difference. Now, carta d'identità is just an identification card. So it means carta d'identità is just like your national ID card. Your carta d'identità is like your national ID card. While your residence, or the certificate of residence when you have one, is like your certificate of a local government of origin. So a certificate that certifies that you are legally registered in that commune. You have an address, you have a house you're staying in that commune. So you are legally registered in that commune. That is your residence, which is different from your character identity. So I don't know if we have been able to understand fully the difference between the character identity and the residence. If you find this video informative and you have been able to have a clearer picture of it, why don't you go ahead and share this video to your loved ones? Share this video across to your friends so that they also can come to understand the difference between carta d'identità and residence. Thank you very much. Until we meet again, remain blessed.